Good day, everyone. This is Dr. Soper here, and today I'd like to welcome you to the first video in this series on cognitive computing and artificial intelligence, or AI. This series of videos is for anyone who is interested in learning more about these topics. I will assume that you have no prior knowledge about AI or cognitive computing systems. Most of us have seen artificial intelligence portrayed in science fiction books or in big-budget Hollywood movies, but this series of videos will focus on truth rather than fiction. Along our journey, we'll learn about what cognitive computing and artificial intelligence are, the various types of cognitive computing and AI systems that are available today, how those systems work, how they are used to solve real-world problems, and the ways in which AI and cognitive computing will transform almost everything we do. We're also going to learn how to use Python and Jupyter notebooks to actually build all of the AI and cognitive systems that we'll discuss, and that will certainly be one of the funnest parts of this series. So, let's get started. Since this first lesson in the series is an introduction to artificial intelligence and cognitive computing, we should begin by defining these terms. Artificial intelligence, put simply, is intelligence demonstrated by machines. AI refers to any artificial device that perceives its environment and takes actions or makes decisions in an effort to successfully achieve its goals. Artificial intelligence systems are unique in that they can learn to solve problems independently. They do not need to be provided with a set of instructions in order to solve a problem or perform a task. Instead, they can learn the best way to solve the problem or perform the task on their own. Cognitive computing, on the other hand, refers to artificial intelligence systems that provide services or handle tasks that could previously only be performed by the human mind. Thus, we can think of all cognitive computing systems as being artificial intelligence systems, but not all artificial intelligence systems are cognitive systems. Some examples of cognitive computing include systems that can learn to detect anomalies or unusual situations, systems that can perform sentiment analysis, translate languages, or perform other natural language processing tasks, systems that can recognize human speech and learn to generate speech on their own, systems that can recognize objects and images, video, or the world around them, and so on. Throughout this series of videos, we'll examine and learn to implement four different types of artificial intelligence models. Each of these models can be used as the basis for a wide variety of cognitive computing systems. First, we'll learn about Thompson sampling, which is one of the simplest AI models to understand and implement. Thompson sampling allows the system to learn what to do when faced with a type of dilemma called the exploration-exploitation dilemma. These types of systems can automatically learn to choose actions that will maximize their expected reward. Next, we'll learn about cue learning, which is a type of reinforcement learning. Cue learning systems involve an agent operating in an environment that is characterized by states and possible actions. Cue learning systems can automatically identify an optimal policy that tells either humans or the system itself what action to take for any given state. Third, we'll learn about deep learning, which involves artificial neural networks. Like the human brain, these neural networks consist of collections of interconnected nodes, or neurons. Deep neural networks are the basis for many of today's most interesting AI and cognitive systems, including those that perform speech recognition, machine translation, medical diagnosis, etc. AI and cognitive systems based on neural networks have even learned to do such things as play video games, paint pictures, and compose music. Finally, we'll learn about deep convolutional neural networks. Convolutional networks learn by using a specialized type of mathematical operation called convolution. Convolutional neural networks have proven themselves to be excellent tools for understanding visual information, such as images and videos. So how will AI and cognitive computing change the world? Well, the possibilities are almost endless. Overall, AI and cognitive computing are expected to contribute nearly $16 trillion to the global economy by 2030. I'm sure you can think of many ways that businesses, governments, and individuals could benefit from cognitive computing and AI. Let's consider just a few specific examples. In the energy sector, AI and cognitive computing will be used to reduce global energy usage by optimizing energy consumption and distribution. In the healthcare sector, AI and cognitive computing will be used to design new drugs and vaccines, diagnose diseases, and deliver highly personalized medical care. In the transportation and logistics sector, AI and cognitive computing will be used to power self-driving vehicles, greatly reduce accidents and traffic congestion, and enable major improvements to e-commerce deliveries. In the education sector, AI and cognitive computing will be used to deliver highly personalized and optimized training and learning experiences. In the safety and security sector, AI and cognitive computing will be used to reduce crime, increase public safety, and reduce fraud and identity theft. In the employment sector, AI and cognitive computing will be used to identify the best candidates for a position and the best positions for a candidate, thus improving people's life satisfaction. In the smart home and home robot sectors, AI and cognitive computing will be used to automate and monitor home devices and equipment and provide live-in robot assistance that will free up time, improve quality of life, and allow older people and people with disabilities to continue to live independently. With respect to entertainment and socialization, AI and cognitive computing will be used to identify and recommend experiences and media and help people find new friends in social circles. With respect to the environment, AI and cognitive computing will be used to improve waste processing and recycling and reduce pollution. Finally, for business, AI and cognitive computing will be used to automate processes, optimize profits, improve innovation, and help managers make better decisions. The preceding examples are just the beginning. There are countless other ways in which AI and cognitive computing will change our lives in the coming years, many of which have not yet even been conceived. If you imagine what the world will be like when all of these things have become reality, then you'll understand why AI and cognitive computing are widely expected to be among the most disruptive technologies in all of human history. They can improve decision-making, enhance human intelligence, and free up our limited cognitive resources so that we are able to focus on other tasks. In light of these and many other advantages, cognitive machines and AI will become so ubiquitous and so seamlessly integrated into everything we do that, like smartphones, the internet, or electricity, we will soon wonder how people ever survived without them. In our next lesson, we'll learn about Jupyter Notebooks, which we will be using in conjunction with Python in this series to actually build and implement all four of the AI models that we discussed a few minutes ago. Again, there's no need to worry if you're not familiar with Jupyter Notebooks or Python, since we'll get a lot of experience learning both of these tools as our journey unfolds. Well, my friends, thus ends our introductory lesson on cognitive computing and artificial intelligence. I hope that you learned something interesting in this lesson, and until next time, have a great day.